With y'all, and I was like, it's a great vibe. It's like 85 degrees in LA right now, and this was just really providing me with a good little vibe. I figure I'd spread that vibe out to you guys. I see some people jumping into the group chat already. Gobble Clan, Shane, Bubble Pug, Justin J, Josh P, Cameron's in here, Thomas McCoy, whoever else is in the background. Personal breaks here on Monday. My name is Card Shop Eric. I'm coming to you live from Hall of Fame Baseball Cards in Arcadia, California. Nothing in the lineup, so to speak, as we get into it here today. But we've chosen a few of those fun discount codes and raffle items from Saturday to keep on the discount and raffle menu for tonight. And yes, Josh P., hopefully some more fire coming up today as well. So take more advantage of the Heritage discount. And when you do, you'll go into a raffle to potentially win a box of Heritage. Take advantage of the Inception discount code on the right-hand side of your screen. And when you do, you'll go into a raffle to potentially win a box of Inception tonight. Take advantage of the Gold Rush 16 by 20s again, and when you do, you'll go into a raffle to win some 16 by 20s.
Well, if it rains, I don't care, don't make no difference to me. Just take that streetcar that's going uptown. Yeah, I like to hear some funky Dixieland and dance. Honky-tonk, and I'll be buying everybody drinks all around. Oh, Blackwater, keep on rolling, Mississippi moon, won't you keep on shining? Oh, Blackwater, keep on rolling, Mississippi moon, won't you keep on shining? Oh, Blackwater, keep on rolling, Mississippi moon, keep on shining. Yeah, keep on shining your light. Gonna make everything pretty, mama. Gonna make everything alright. And I ain't got no worries, 'cause I ain't in no hurry at all. Do 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 Dixieland, pretty mama, come and take me. I'd like to hit some funky Dixieland, pretty mama, come and take me. I'd like to hear some funky Dixieland, pretty mama, come and take me. By the hand, take me by the hand, pretty mama, dance with your daddy all night long. I'd like to hear some funky Dixieland, pretty mama, come and take me. By the hand, take me by the hand, pretty mama, dance with your daddy all night long. Like to hear some funky Dixieland, pretty mama, come and take me by the hand, take me by the hand, pretty mama, dance with your daddy all night long. Like to hear some funky Dixieland, pretty mama, come and take me by the hand. Take me by the hand, pretty mama, dance with your daddy all night long. Like to hear some funky Dixieland, pretty mama, come and take me by the hand, take me by. Come on, baby, come on, baby.
Kicking it off today on a little Monday. A little something by the Doobie Brothers, because it sounded right to me earlier. What's happening out there in YouTube land? I'm Card Shop Eric, once again, back with you here, live at Hall of Fame Baseball Cards, Arcadia, California. And looking to rip. Take advantage of some of those discounts we got going on. How's everybody doing out there in YouTube land? Why don't you tell me what's happening? Let's do some locations right now. Where's everybody watching from? I'm going to tell you what kind of temperature we got going right now. In sunny Arcadia, we're looking at sunny and 88 degrees in Arcadia, California. What's the temperature like in your location? Drop some locations with some current temperatures right now. Let's talk about some locations right now. What's coming up, folks? What's coming up on the program today? It's just going to be me running things again, like it was on Saturday. So I'm going to have to be popping back and forth to the front and the back, checking to see if there's been some orders coming in. What's up, Paul? Pablo Bo Baddies in Monrovia, also 88 degrees. Bubble Pug, cloudy in 44 in Wisconsin. Cameron's reporting about 70 and sunny in Spokane, Washington. That sounds nice. Josh P. is looking good down in sunny San Diego at a nice mellow 75 degrees. Dark Senshi, clear sky and sun in Surprise, Arizona. So yeah, the western seaboard here, the western states here, looking pretty good. 89 degrees in Surprise. Yeah, it's warming up. Tyler Jones is in Maryland where it's 59 and raining. Okay, that's cool. I like the rain. It was raining here a few days ago. This is last weekend, last week. Some light rain popping through. And now again, it's 90 degrees. Todd, sunny and 50 degrees in Coeur d'Alene, Idaho. There we go. What's up, Todd, AKA The Beard? That's crazy how it's like a 20 degree difference between Coeur d'Alene and Spokane right now. It's only about maybe 45 minutes, an hour drive in between the two cities. Similar parts of the states up there in the northern to northwest. So yeah, we're looking good. I'm going to be go checking the computer here in just a moment to see if by chance someone's trying to pop in and grab some orders. Be sure to take care of those discount codes on the right-hand side. Use the code HER to get $15 off your Heritage boxes, just like Saturday. Use the code INC to get $30 off your Inception boxes. Use the code GOLD RUSH for $25 off those 16x20s. And as long as we activate those raffles, we'll be raffling off some prizes. So give me a minute, folks. I'm gonna step away. I'm gonna check the computer, see if anything came through, and hopefully I will be coming back with arms full of stuff to rip.
What's shaking, good people? Cardshop Man here, oldest baseball card employee in the world and America's oldest and longest running baseball card shop. Just thought I'd pop in and say hello. How you guys doing? I see you guys in the chat. Lots of good codes tonight on this fine Monday kickoff to the week. Been some exciting baseball this weekend. I'm sure you guys have watched. San Diego and Los Angeles Dodgers was definitely something to watch. I don't know if you guys caught that, but I just wanted to say hi. And say welcome to Hall of Fame Personal Breaks. Anyways, I'll catch you guys soon.
No action yet, folks. So I'm going to come in here and maybe try to coax some people down the runway here. We did drop some links into the group chat with the direct links to those products with the corresponding codes there. If you want to use those, turn my attention to the insider in the group chat who's saying, found us on Beckett, grew up in St. Gabriel in the 90s, didn't know you guys exist. Yeah, well, we do. We do. In the 90s, there were a ton of shops that opened up at the same time as we did. It was kind of like the boom that's happening now. And of all those shops that opened up, they're all closed, and we're the last of the Mohicans. And we're a pretty small location, so even if you were to drive by, I know people that live locally that say, man, I've driven by here for years, never noticed it. And I always joke by saying, yeah, if you blink while you're driving by, you'll miss us, because we're that small. But we're right on Foothill Boulevard in Arcadia, just west of Fifth Avenue, for those of you that might know the area. And been here for 30 years, but we've been in business for 40 years, folks, as an official business. The longest running family-owned operation in the card industry. So if you want to jump in with us, we'd be happy to have you. You'll get in line right now, you'll get ripped right now. And help us create a little content for our YouTube channel and other people that might be watching right now. We got some of the best prices to offer. You get with that code, you'll be getting Heritage boxes for $135 ripped and shipped. With the Inception code, you'll be getting those boxes for $150 ripped and shipped. With the Gold Rush code, you'll be getting those 16x20s for $125 ripped and shipped. And then we got a bunch of other current products, market value pricing, and things of that nature. If you want to have ripped, we can rip anything that we got. Be sure to use those links in the group chat to find the Personal Breaks pages of our website. If you do want something ripped, make sure it does say the words Personal Break in the product title. That is the way that it lets us know that that product is meant to be opened live on camera. Every other product, if it does not say Personal Break in the title, it will be regularly shipped to you without being ripped. Be sure to take advantage of, if you want Personal Breaks, make sure to choose a Personal Break item. You will get free shipping on your Personal Break items. And if you're new with us, sign up for HOFBC Team Rewards. Hopefully it's working. I was meant to mention that today to Maddie, but I forgot. But hopefully it's working. There was a little bit of a hair in the bug. What am I trying to say? I just lost my train of thought. It wasn't working very well last Saturday, but hopefully the Team Rewards are working better for people that need to sign up for that, because you will get 5% credit on all your purchases with us that you, then you can accrue and use towards future purchases. So we're doing our best to try to let people know that we do give back to the hobby with our free shipping, with our 5% back, with our discount codes, with our raffle items, and with our overall charm. Hall of Fame baseball card since 1981. Dark Senji. In August, I'm going to be in Cali and was wondering if I can walk in and buy cards. I have to buy some off the website and pick them up. We are currently open in store Monday through Saturday, 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. You're welcome to give us a call just to make sure. But yeah, those are our hours. So feel free to stop by anytime in those hours and come check us out when you can. Is the Chronicles baseball able to be ripped live? Should be. We should be having that. Let's check out what's happening here. I'm going to take you to our website here. Let's see where... This is all of our personal break stuff, and you'll see all the titles have the words personal break in the title. That lets you know that it is available to be ripped live. Let's see if there's some Chronicles hiding up here somewhere. I'm not sure if we have any more of that for personal breaks. There's a box right there if you're talking about Chronicles baseball. Chronicles baseball, there we go. Personal break, Chronicles baseball right there. So if you want to get into that, I can even drop the direct link for that into the group chat. There it is. And then at the bottom, you can see 9 different pages of personal break items. The last page will usually have some upcoming pre-sale personal break items, which you can find on the last page. And you can also check out our store and check out any regular items, baseball, basketball, football, hockey, any other sports, wrestling, soccer, etc. Some single cards we might have to offer. You can check out our pre-sale products on this page here. You'll see Bowman Hobbies coming up. Panini Diamond Kings is coming up. Topps Tier 1 is coming up. So a bunch of stuff, a bunch of fun. And this is just the ones that we've had the opportunity to put up so far. So there we go. I'm going to keep popping in back and forth to check out sales in the back and see if anything's coming in. I'm going to do that right now. Hopefully there's some people checking out. Hey, everybody, we're back. Cameron jumped on a... I'm surprised that something's going on, but we have a couple of these single packs available to get ripped, so he's going to get a single pack, and then we'll look at Riley's full box of Chronicles right there. So let's do that. Thanks, guys. Cameron, let's see what the pack has in it. Yeah, Yordi, Rizzo, Castillo... who we got here? Autograph of Cesar Hernandez, 43 out of 50. Cleveland. That's Susugo. We got Baez again. La Rosarena and Susugo. A little cracked ice Phoenix out of 99. There you go, Cameron. Cameron getting a little quick fix there. What's up, Soup? Everybody say what's up to Soup Man, a.k.a. Luis Valdez. What's up, buddy? Now we're going to open this full box for Riley, and hopefully some people are getting up next in line here for us. You can use the link that's pinned to the top of the group chat to get to our personal breaks web pages and place an order, and we'll rip it for you in the next 10 minutes. All right, Riley, how about a little Spectra Auto? Okay. Spectra Autos are known to come out of here, so I wouldn't be surprised if we're finding one here. Here's Shun Yamaguchi, Aaron Judge, and Bobby Bradley. Got a little Spectra insert of Dustin May. That's nice. Numbered out of 49. A little green kaleidoscope. Hello, Luis Robert. Some Shun Yamaguchi, some Cody Bellinger. Okay. Wrong sleeve. Let's try it with this Robert just for fun. It's kind of a nice Luis Robert card. I like the titanium rookie. It's pretty simple, clean. Okay. Jesse A is up in the lineup with some Donruss. Jesse, I haven't heard that name for a minute. Hope you're doing all right. Here's Mike Trout on the titanium. And Trout on the green parallel. I'll drop a sleeve on the green, even though it's not numbered. It's still kind of neat parallels. And behind Javier Baez, we have, there you go. How about Andres Munoz on the Spectra, what I like to call Soda Pop Blue, on-card RPA. Numbered 57 of 99. There you go, Riley. Second, what is that? Second pack. And getting what you're looking for. Cool. So far, so good. Bubble Pug's loving the blue. Machado, Marte, what do you guys think about the Padres this season? Do you think they have what it takes? Or are they going to be plagued by bad luck and injury? Here's Starling Marte. Here's a little Abraham Toro, 2 out of 50. Yordan, we got Bichette. Nice. We got JD. We got a Luis Robert. Another nice Luis Robert, Titan. Drop a sleever on your Bichette, too. And how about Victor Caratini? Cubs autograph out of 25. 20 out of 25 on the left, I think that's 10 out of 25 on the left-hand side. Bubble Pug says the Brewers better beat them tonight. Are the Brewers and Padres playing tonight, I guess, huh? Josh P. doing okay for now. Dodgers are just rolling. Dodgers are rolling. And I expect the Dodgers to kind of steamroll. I don't expect them, but I hope they steamroll the whole season. Padres will win wild card and fall to the Dodgers, says Baseball Everything. Riley says, not bad. I'm a Cubs fan, though. He did go to the go in the Darvish deal. There we go. Was that who? Caratini did? Here's Bogarts, Clevenger, and McKay. We got Marte, Nico Horner, another Luis Robert. This looks like a green parallel titanium. Nice. Scherzer and Torres. Cool. Susugo with two packs left. Bregman. Tony Gonsolin hit behind him. We go Vladdy. We go Shogo. A little Trent Grisham. And how about Shohei Ohtani on the Contenders Optic season ticket green? That's very Christmassy. It's numbered 11 of 50. Nice looking prism refractor there. And behind Gonsolin, we have some more Spectra. It's Miguel Cabrera. Relic on the Spectra Soda Pop Blue. Numbered out of 25. So there's some more Spectra for you. Real quick, let me grab a, some penny sleeves here. With his last pack. Then we're moving on to Jesse's Donruss. Here's Mike Trout. Another Luis Robert. Hit behind Verlander. We got Judge. Trout on the green. Nice. Another green Trout is good. About Trent Grisham on the Mosaic Silver and Pete Alonso on the Crusade Base. This Trent Grisham's pretty nice. Trout green, also cool. And how about Randy Arozarena on another Spectra on-card RPA? That's hot right there. That was a pretty good box of Chronicles for Riley J. Riley, what do you think about that box, man? I like all the red on this card. It's pretty dope. Let's sleeve it up and see what the back says. $24 out of $199, it looks like. Awesome box, says Riley. You gotta believe it, buddy. Pretty darn good. Congratulations and thanks for jumping in with us tonight. Was able to sleeve up a bunch of stuff from that box. Let's just take another quick look. Just a quick look. Rosarena, some Trout green, Grisham, Miggy, Shohei green, Luis Robert green. Beau Bichette, some more Luis Robert, some Trout green, some Munoz, some May, and some more Robert. Yeah. Pretty darn cool. All right, Jesse. Thank you, Riley. All right, Jesse, let's get into some Donruss for you, buddy. This is maybe our last box of Donruss in the house. I'm not sure. I know we don't have much left. Let's see what happens. have single slash cheap card packs? That's one of our favorite questions. Hey, what's the cheapest product you have? We have a bunch of different packs. Yeah, if you come into the store, you'll find some big league and you'll find some opening day packs for whatever, you know, a couple bucks a piece or whatever. You might even find some older stuff, some vintage wax and some 90s packs in here. But yes, here's Trevor Bauer out of 100. Andy Pettit. Last Box Magic. What's up, Jesse? How you been, buddy? What's up, Mark O? I see Mark O commenting on the Arozarena, I'm guessing, signature, right? Yeah, he does have a unique sig. It's Starling Marte out of 2021 here, and Max Fried. Looking for three hits per box on Donruss, I believe. Molitor, Harper, well, Dominic Smith, and Bam Bam. Dominic Smith out of 149, and Bam Bam. A little, might be a little foil nickname variation. Oh no, not the gum. Have you ever done that challenge? You may not know this, but I'm the one that invented that challenge. I'm not even joking about that. Yeah, the Vintage Bubblegum Challenge. Ask anybody in the chat. Here's Casey Mize out of 2021 and little Fernando Tatis on a blue parallel. Solano, Burns, Carew, Senzatella, Dylan Bundy on the Stars, and J.P. Crawford foil. Got 534 slugging for Sosa, Cattell, Big Sexy, and Justin Turner. See, 14-time All-Star Aroyd, Vlad Jr., got Brian Anderson out of 2021, and Vlad Sr. See, Joey Bart, Scherzer, Christian Pache, nice little gold ish rookie out of 999, and Rafael Devers, Diamond Kings. It's a nice Pache, the rookies right there. I like the design they used on these the rookies this year. Arenado, Dalbec, Bigfoot out of 2021, and Big Hurt on the foil. Nice. Tyler Jones posing a question to the group chat. Group chatters, do you think Miguel Cabrera will be in the Hall of Fame? File your answers in the group chat. Here's Charlie Blackman at a 999 and Paul Molitor. Marte, Ruiz, Devers out of 498, and Kyle Tucker. Still yet to find our first hit. Jimenez, Tatis, Lusardo, 2021, and Rendon. Pico de Gallo,
Whit Merrifield and Cole Calhoun. Soup, the only person to respond about Miggy, and he says, doubt it. CJ goes, what? Shohei on a blue, and behind Arenado here, we've got our first autograph. It's going to be Bobby Dalbec. Donruss Signature Series autograph. That's my boy Ricky Henderson. I don't think I have one of these from the new Donruss yet. Jesse, I wonder if you wouldn't mind if I snag that for the PC, let me know. If not, obviously no big deal. But I usually like to ask. Dylan Bundy, you got Scherzer on the foil. You got Devers there. We've got Nate Pearson. And then we've got Jose Abreu on a career highlights relic. Oral Hershiser, loving it. 1406 career steals. I believe I do have that parallel, though. Hey, CJ, is there any Donruss cards sitting on the table right there? For me, for my collection? A little stack?
Donruss?
Yeah, any 21?
The 1406 career steals.
Okay, so I do have that one. Cool, but yeah. I don't have the regular one, which is...
No, you only have the blue one.
The same picture, just the regular one is a smaller, slightly smaller image. There's Tatis out of 21 and Bryce Harper, 2021. Pete Alonso. Craig Biggio out of 2021 and Nate Pearson on some blue foil. Joe Adell rated rookie. Pico de Gallo. Albert Pujols on the Stars. And Kyle Lewis. Copy that, Jesse. Thank you, my man. Doogie, Voigt, we got Mize rated rookie, Chris Bryant, we got Judge Foyle, and behind Chris Bryant, how about Monte Harrison? Little signature series autograph, Monte Harrison. Five packs to go. Babe Ruth there. Madrigal rated. Marte, Scherzer out of 2021, and Giambi of the Jason variety. Larry Walker. We pulled a triple relic from the Rockies out of Heritage the other day. Larry Walker and I think it was Arenado and one other player. Juan Soto here, Luis Patino, got Rendon out of 2021, and you got Pete Alonso, DK. Timmy's jumping on board with a box of Phoenix from 2020 Phoenix football. Here's Troy Gloss. He used to like Gloss, he was cool. Christian Yelich there, Judge, Bohm. We got a little CJ Abrams out of 249 and Andres Jimenez. Steve Garvey there. We pulled a Steve Garvey autograph out of Heritage the other day. Tim Anderson there, Chris Bryant, Stars, and Sandy Alcantara. Last pack in the box for you, Jesse. O'Reilly is on board with a couple single packs, too. Thanks, CJ, for setting that up. Ronald Acuna, DK in the last pack. Colton Wong out of 350. And Brad Hand rounding out the box. Nice Christian Pache, the rookies there. Cool looking card for sure. Nickname foil, you got Jose Abreu, Monty Harrison, and Bobby Dalbec. What's up, Tim? Tim's causing trouble in the group chat again. What's up, buddy? Thanks, Jesse. Good to see you, man. Do these couple of packs for Riley, and then that box of Phoenix for Tim. Let's do the select football first. You're welcome, Jesse. Thank you. Oh, and thanks for that, Ricky Henderson, of course. Another one in the PC there. I love the small cards. All right, Riley, let's see what's happening here. You got Joshua Kelly on the back and Joe Burrow base rookie on the, excuse me, Kelly on the front, Burrow on the back. Reset. Sleeve up Burrow base. Those are probably still going for a few dollars. Newton. We've got T it up, Higgins. And Joe Reed. Chargers rookie, silver. So there you go, not terrible. At least you got a Joe Burrow base rookie. Let's see what's in your tribute. Tribute, three cards, thick one in the middle. Aaron Nola on the front. Babe Ruth on the back. Nice. And the Z-Hit. What a Matt Olson, triple relic. 140 out of 150. Matt Olson. All right, Riley, two more packs. Up and down for you. Thanks for jumping in again. Savage Crew asking my opinion on Topps Heritage. It's a good set. It's a fun set. It's a set builder's set, meaning it's designed for people to buy boxes and hand collate their own sets out of them. That's my brief opinion. Tim A. Jumping on some 2020 Phoenix football from Panini. Two autos and one memorabilia card per box on average. Let's see how it goes. I'm going to start with this pack that was hanging out the front here with kind of a crinkly top on it. Switching to football gear here, folks. Xavier Howard, by the way, for those of you who missed it, we pulled a sweet football card on Saturday. Is it in your pocket or something, CJ? It's in the front. No, that's all right. Here's Xavier Howard, Derwin James, Chase Claypool on the back. Behind James, we've got the Skittle. Right here, we've got Tyler Lockett on the hot routes. And behind the Skittle, we have a decoy. Skittle out of 149. Sanders on the front, Watkins on the back, Brian Edwards rookie, Terry Bradshaw flamethrower, and how about Tua on the flamethrower out of 149. There we go, warming it up. I'm going to pull a pack from the back of the stack here. Mix it up. Chris Godwin on the front of this one. Josh Uke or Yuki on the back, I'm not sure. Rookie out of Michigan. We've got Devontae Parker. We've got Zach Ertz on the game over. And we've got Len Dawson on the flamethrower out of 99. /96 for Len Dawson. Pull another one from the back. Savage Crew is asking the group chat, what's your favorite baseball movie? Why don't we put in our favorite baseball movies into the group chat right now? Mine is probably The Natural, starring Robert Redford. Here's Larry Fitzgerald. Here's T. Higgins. Daniel Jones. Damon Arnett and Troy Aikman, Fire Forged. Arnett out of 175. Bubble Pug's favorite baseball movie is Major League. Here's Matt Ryan, McFarland Jr., Stafford. Got a little Jonathan Taylor pink, and about Anthony Gordon rookie auto. Cameron likes Bull Durham. Gordon, not numbered. Taylor should be numbered. 75? No, 199. Numbered out of 199. Dark Senshi likes bench warmers. Trent Griffin likes The Sandlot. Mark O likes The Fan. I don't know what The Fan is. I don't know if I've heard of that baseball movie. Here's Travis Kelce and Julian Aquara. Also got David Johnson here. DiNucci and CeeDee Lamb, rookie rising, not numbered. DiNucci out of 35, I believe that says. Dee Woodruff's claiming a league of their own with Tom Hanks. Good one. Lou Soup. Ninja Turtle isn't a baseball movie. Unless you count that one scene where he's got the bat and he swings, right? Doesn't he have a baseball bat? Knocks out one of the... Oh, The Fan, yes, with Wesley Snipes. Yes, I have seen that movie. Is that a baseball movie? I thought that was a football movie. Maybe I'm thinking of something else, but I thought The Fan was a football movie. Or maybe I'm thinking of... Maybe something else. Here's J.J. Watt. What's up, James M.? J.J. Watt, Joe Burrow-based rookie on the back here. It's not bad. It's the one guy I know that people like. Joe Burrow. There he is. Sam Darnold. Not too many people like him right now. Matt Stafford. Isn't he coming like somewhere? The Rams or something?
Yeah, he's in the Rams.
He's currently on the Rams?
Yeah.
And how about Cortland Sutton on a little gold? Oh, James, that's the last Boy Scout. Wasn't that like Bruce Willis and... one of the Wayans brothers. This is out of 75, Cortland Sutton. That was a good movie, though, The Last Boy Scout. James M. likes The Natural as well. Phil X going with Bad News Bears. James Damon Wayans, there you go. Jeff Okuda, Kenny Golladay, Frank Clark. Nice. Jalen Reagor, not numbered on the hot routes. And how about a little Derrick Henry? A little red action. Have I hit any hits yet? Just that one autograph so far, huh? Just one autograph we've hit so far. Let me go back to it real quick. There it is. A lot of nice color, but just one autograph, one hit so far. Where's the next hit? We got two more hits to find. Let's go with this pack on the right. Whoops, jumping out of my hands. Maybe that means it's a hot one. What's up, Steven S? Josh Jacobs here. Desmond Patman there. Todd Gurley. Nice Barry Sanders, fire forged. And behind him, we got Cortland Sutton again. Second hit's your material card. Nice patch, Cortland Sutton. You got a patch, you got a numbered parallel, and now you just need a Sutton autograph to complete the trifecta. Steven, currently nothing except a little Coca-Cola. I might be persuaded to get into something a little bit later. But we'll see. Devontae Parker, Phillip Rivers, Antonio Gibson, Chenault Jr. with a decoy, and Baker Mayfield. Chenault's out of 299. Well, where's this other autograph going to be? Are you sipping on something there, Steven? Here's Marquise Brown, Jeff Gladney, Devontae Adams, Juju Smith-Schuster on a little pink and gold. That's cool looking. And behind him, how about Henry Ruggs on the dual relic rookie autograph for the last hit in the box. Out of 75. Schuster out of 199. The dope looking card. I love the color scheme there. Last pack for you, Tim A. In this box, at least. Here's Darren Waller, Jalen Reagor, Andre Johnson, Eno Benjamin, and Barry Sanders. This one is numbered. Benjamin not numbered, but the Barry Sanders this time is numbered. To end the box, it's numbered out of 299. So there you go, Tim. Box of 2020 Phoenix football held a lot of color for you. All that color. Look at all that color. Schuster, Sutton, Burrow, Taylor, Tua. All right, thank you, Tim. Coming up now, it's going to be Jamie G jumping out of Box of Heritage. Tim says, what a skunker. Yeah, not thrilling. Maybe not even nice. And after this Heritage, we got a 16 by 20 coming up for Jesse. Jamie G, looks like you got a Mike Trout poster here. Your box topper. It's a little dinged up at the top, but what can you expect for just a folded up piece of paper on the top of a hobby box that looks like Mike Trout? Scooby-Doo. Having a hard time with promo code for Inception. Are you able to be more specific? What do you mean by having a hard time? All right, here, Jamie G, let's check out your first pack here of Heritage for the evening. Oh, wow, after we went all weekend without finding a hot box. Look at this. It looks like Jamie G pulled the trigger at the right time. We'll confirm it with the next couple of packs, but hey, there's a purple refractor in the first pack. Usually a solid indication of a hot box. Let's see what's happening. Let's do another pack. Let's do another random pack at the bottom. We'll do one right over here, bottom right over here. And yep, hot box, there it is. Jamie G, we went all weekend ripping Heritage. And we were all talking on Saturday. Man, haven't seen a hot box yet. Not for a minute. And here it is. Riley says the inception code's not working for him. CJ, do you have the ability to check to see it, make sure the inception code's still working? As far as just try to check out with something.
Yeah, I just did it. Worked.
Oh, CJ says it's working fine, so maybe try it again, Riley.
Just put INC.
Yeah, INC is the code. INC, like it says on the right hand side of the screen. All right, so we're kind of going to bust through Shohei Ohtani on a little hot box action. Nice, this is great. These look great in the purple chrome. I'm still waiting for Topps to put out a standalone Heritage Chrome set. I'm sure they'll be doing that in the next year or two if they're not doing it this year. Heritage Chrome and Gypsy Queen Chrome I'm waiting for. Here's Paul Goldschmidt. Saucy, you gotta remind me which person you are in real life. Justin Smoke, Robbie Ray, here's Brandon Lau, purple. Jorge Soler on the purple. Brian O. There you are. Okay. Thank you, Brian. You did win a box. Yeah, you won the box that had the Luis Robert autograph, too. That was pretty dope. Here's Justin Verlander, purple. Nolan Arenado, purple. These purples look really, really kind of cool and very even more 70s to me with the purple border. Very cool. Ah, how about an on-card autograph in the box, too, to boot? Dylan Carlson, on-card rookie auto. So it's a true hot box. CJ, have you noticed anything like that where hot boxes always have an autograph or anything?
No.
It's not like that? Well, cool. This makes it even more special. Jamie G got to be loving it. And there's Didi Gregorius there in the pack with him. Yeah, my hands have been pretty hot lately. Been having some fun things come through. Max Scherzer, purple. Got a little Dylan Carlson and Evan White. think you dropped the microphone intentionally for Rihanna. No, Rihanna. Let's wait at the end of the night. It was you that got the Luis Robert auto, correct? Out of Inception? Was that you or was that somebody else? He says no Robert auto. I think you dropped the mic on that Ted Williams framed auto. Oh, maybe it was Saturday night that the Robert auto came out? Is that what you're saying? So yeah, drop the mic. Maybe so Friday night was the Ted Williams, and then I said, yeah, we're going to end it there, and I didn't rip anything else. Saturday night, I think then, one of those two nights, whoever won the Inception box pulled a Luis Robert auto out of it, which was cool. Apologies if that wasn't you. Well, Joey Votto on the purple. Brendan McKay, yes, I do remember that, yes, which is not too shabby either. Good young pitcher. Nice Joe Adell. Nick Madrigal, rookie stars purple. That's a dope looking card in the chrome purple. '20 rookie stars. Garcia, Anderson, and Javier. Freeman. Zach Greinke. Mike Soroka. Luis Robert, rookie. This one's got the rookie logo on it, CJ. Did you know that? This purple chrome Luis Robert actually has the RC logo on it. This could be interesting, folks. That could be a big card. That could be a really big card. I'm not trying to get overly excited, but I am excited.
I've seen them with the gold code, but not.
Yeah, no. Now all of the regular base cards have the gold cup on the left, but no RC because last year was his rookie. Now someone's gonna have to look into this. Maybe CJ, if you got a minute, you might want to look into it, see if there's anything like this or. But that could be cool if that's considered an official rookie card. That could be sick. Okay, so a sleeve on that. Chris Sale here. Shane Bieber. Three packs left. All Luis Robert Chrome cards have the rookie card error. So Aaron N is saying it's an error. Does that mean they're going for, so that's not a rookie card then? It's just an error rookie? That's interesting. It's definitely weird. Here's Zach Wheeler. I wonder if they're going for anything decent. Probably not then if they printed a bunch of them. But who knows? Maybe. It's neat. It's neat regardless. How's that Corey Seager? A little base chrome in the middle of this pack. Along with a purple chrome. Corey Seager's numbered out of 999. This has been a great box of Heritage. One of the best I've seen. And Bryce Harper, purple chrome in that same box. Last pack of the box. And what a box it was for Jamie G. Good Lord. Ending with Eloy Jimenez on the purple. He got a hot box here. which means every pack had a purple chrome card in it. Here they all are. Look at that bling right there. And then you got the Corey Seager numbered. You got the Luis Robert purple, I guess, rookie card error logo card. And then a Dylan Carlson on card rookie auto. That was a great box. I mean, the only way it could have been bigger is if maybe the auto was bigger, you know, it was better.
That's a good one, though.
But still, that's really nice, man. Awesome. Really nice box for Jamie G. Not sure where you are, Jamie, but hopefully you're stoked on that. Good stuff. Oh, here. And the Mike Trout box topper poster to boot. That just kept getting better.
The photo first.
Huh?
Photo.
Oh, photo and then a box of Inception. Photo for Jesse.
So was it three to activate all of them?
Yeah.
So two of each.
So we need to sell two more 16 by 20s to activate the raffle and two more Inception to activate the raffle. And two more Heritage to activate the raffle. That's what I've reported. That's what was reported to me, so I'm reporting it back to you guys. Let's see which way we're gonna go with this, and I have a feeling Jesse is gonna like this one. I caught a glimpse of it, and it's one that we've seen before, but it's a classic. Welch's McGee saying, "Shop, you're the coolest. I want to have my own shop one day, too." What's up, Welch's McGee? Jesse, we've seen this before on our program. I don't think you have one, but I can't remember who's got one or not because we've pulled this at least once or twice before, but it's Nolan Ryan. Folks, these Gold Rush 16x20s have been absolutely on fire lately. If you want some stuff for a good price that has some great legendary autographed photos... to decorate your room or your garage or your man cave or your gym or whatever with, pick up some Gold Rush 16x20s. These things are great. Look at this. Nolan Ryan. Little bit bloody. Little blood stained right there. Cameron Diaz into it. He should know. He should know 16x20s by now. But yeah, that is nice. That is nice. So 16 by 20s, folks. Let's get a couple more of those going tonight, huh? Jesse. All right, and now a quick rip for Todd R. Some Inception. Let's see if Inception stays hot from the weekend. All right, looks like you might have a little auto patch in here. So that's already a good start. Starting off with Brady Singer, Evan White rookie. Charlie Blackman, Matt Chapman, Ryan Mountcastle, and Shohei. And let's go this way with it. It's going to be Pirates. How about Ke'Bryan Hayes? Kaboom.
There you go.
79 out of 150, Ke'Bryan Hayes RPA. Inception continues to hit at Hall of Fame Baseball Cards. America's longest running family-owned brick and mortar in the card industry. Believe it or not, folks. I'm not sure what incident that Nolan Ryan photo was taken from. You might be thinking of Robin Ventura, How they had the brawl. Was that from the Robin Ventura brawl?
Yeah.
CJ thinks it was from the Robin Ventura brawl. This is a sweet Brian Hayes. All right, folks. Two more boxes of Inception need to be sold to activate that raffle. Now that you've seen how hot it is, who's next? We got nothing in the lineup. I'm going to take a quick break.
Coming.
Oh, something coming?
Yeah.
Your okay. Riley's trying some more select football. Three times over. Todd 74, there you go. That must be Todd R. Great hit, buddy. Riley, let's see what these three packs hold for you. Chase Young on the back. Perrine on the back, excuse me. Chase Young on the front. Behind him is Josh Allen. Behind Josh Allen is James Conner and Isaiah Wilson. I like the white prisms. They look pretty cool and different. White, black, and gold like that looks pretty good. It's number 3 out of 35, believe it or not. Next pack. Julio Jones on the front, little Tommy Stevens on the back, Jerry Jeudy base rookie, J.K. Dobbins on the silver, and behind Jeudy we've got a little Daniel Jones relic. Daniel Jones relic, numbered out of 49. Third pack for Riley, and then we'll be looking for someone who's going to be up next in the lineup. Who's going to be next? Get ripped right now, folks. No waiting. No waiting at this particular moment in time. Here's Sam Darnold and Pittman Jr. Jordan Fuller. Jake Fromm and Juju Smith-Schuster on the silvers. That's the way those three packs are going to go for Riley. All right, folks, and now we might be at our first pause of the evening. I'm going to step away for a moment, check out what's going on in the back, and then we'll be right back when there's something to rip. All right, we got four packs of Chronicles here for Matt L. Matt L. Let's see what's going on here. Luis Robert on the top of this first pack. Garrett Cole, Dustin May. We've got Corey Seager on a Prism Relic there. Baez, Soto, Baez, and Cody Bellinger on a cool little Titan colored parallel. Mojo, 57 out of 75. That's a nice looking card. So a couple nice Dodgers in that pack for Matt L. Shogo, Cody, Lux, hit behind him. Got Murphy, Lux again, May on the Obsidian, and Acuna. And behind this Lux, we have Steven Gonsalves, Spectra on card signature. Out of 199. Gavin Lux here, Vladdy, DeGrom hit behind him. We got Soto, we got Mendick, Jalen Davis, and Nick Solak. Behind DeGrom, we had, how about Gavin Lux on the select green kaleidoscope RPA? That is nasty. 2 out of 25. There you go, Matt. That's sick. Wow. You don't often see them with actual patches on them. Mostly it's like a relic. But that's a great looking card. Anybody who wants to look at our personal break items that we have to offer, there's a link that's pinned to the top of the group chat that'll take you to our personal break items. We also have a search engine there. You can search for products, whatever you like. Here's Mike Trout, Luis Robert, Aquino, Harper, and Shogo. And behind this Soto, we've got Ozzy Albies, a little relic. What's up, Richard? Check out this card we just pulled for Matt L. Beautiful Gavin Lux kaleidoscope. So there we go. That was a good little pickup there for Matt. I'll be going to check out the, see if there's anything coming through, and I'll be back when we got something to rip. All right, back to find something for Richard Martinez. Jumping on one of the last Gold Rush autographed baseballs we have in stock. Might have one more hiding. I can't tell from here, but let's see what's in this one right now. So the Gold Rush stuff has been fun for us. They got some pretty good autographs coming out of their mystery signed products, which include baseballs, jerseys, photos, bats, helmets, all sorts of fun stuff that they put out in different configurations. This is the autographed baseball edition for 2021. And they usually put out a Series 2. So we'll probably be getting some Series 2 baseballs when those come out. All right, let's check out who it is. I feel like I should recognize this. That's not Tatis's autograph, is it? Shoot, it is! Fernando Tatis right there, boom. How about that, Richard? Got one of those yet? If this kid could stop getting injured, stuff's gonna be worth something someday. Tatis. So that's just a little taste of what Gold Rush can do for you folks. If you're into memorabilia, if you're into collectibles, if you're into sports autographs that are nice to collect and nice to display and nice to show off to your friends and sometimes nice to use for trade bait, or jump on some Gold Rush. It's different. It's fun. Highly collectible. And in some cases, pretty valuable. In the case of this ball, this one's going to be worth a couple of bucks to somebody. So there we go, Richard. That was a good choice for you right now. Boom, baby. Who's going to be next, folks? I'm going to go check out the lineup, see if anything's coming through. We'll be back when we have some more stuff to rip. All right, coming up with a 16 by 20 for Richard. We need to sell one more of these 16 by 20s to activate the raffle on that for tonight. We need to sell two more Inception and two more Heritage for those raffles to activate. All right, let's see who we got here. Oh, man, we just pulled this guy last week. Who was it for? Was it for you, Richard? I forget who it was, too. It's the Eagles. Dawkins? Is that who we said it was? I just don't like getting doubles. I wish there was never a double in any product. But it's a cool autograph, to be honest. Football fans, Philadelphia Eagles fans. White signature up in the corner there. Oops. Dawkins, there you go, Cameron. Did you pull one of these last week, Cameron? Was it for you? Somebody hit one last week. Richard doesn't have it, so it must have been Cameron at this rate. So that's good. Richard doesn't have this one in our collections. Oh, we pulled that one? Maddie's watching. Maybe you're right. Yes, we did. There we go. Here it is. There it is. There's our Dawkins. Yeah. So there you go, Richard. Another photo that you don't have. So that in itself is a feat. Alright, folks, what's happening? Anybody up there want to get into some things? Take the edge off on a Monday night. We're here to rip for you. Be sure to check out and use those codes that we rolled back from last weekend. Mostly because those are the products we have most of. So that's what we can offer discounts on. Everything else is pretty short stocked with us right now. But we try to do what we have. We do what we can. Chat with Card Shop Matt in the group chat if you like. I'm going to go check the computer, see if there's anything rolling in. Hey, just popping in to check in with y'all. If you're trying to check out, we're just encouraging you to proceed straight down the runway to your exit and get something going in the lineup for us right now. We still have at least over an hour in our regularly scheduled program for this evening. And we'd be happy to rip longer than that if people want to stick around longer and make some things happen. Don't forget to check out Topps Heritage Code on your right-hand side, Inception Baseball Code, Gold Rush 16x20 codes right there. So if you're thinking about jumping in, maybe just do it. Check out. Maybe that encouraged a few people to kind of slip down that runway. Let's go find out. Hey, thanks to Ed B for popping onto a box of Heritage, giving the rest of you guys some time to peruse the website while we're ripping some more Heritage for Ed here. Which means we only need to sell one more box of Heritage to activate that raffle. One more Gold Rush 16x20 to activate that raffle. We still need to sell two more boxes of Inception to activate that raffle. If any of that sounds good to you guys, you know what to do. If you don't know what to do, just ask. Ed, what's happening, my man? Let's see what's cracking. You get Jose Altuve as your box topper. Oh. Isn't that just a face only a mother could love? And even his mother's probably like, why you be cheating for? All right, starting off with the Cy Young Award. What's up, Ed? Hanging in. How are you? About the same, buddy. About the same. Just keeping it all together here on a Monday. Who are you looking for? Are you looking for anything in particular out of this set right now, Ed? Are you just kind of having some fun and getting some cards to build your sets with, or what? Where are you at with all the Heritage right now? When are you going to do Pack Wars again? It's a good question. I've been telling people every time I get that question that we'll be setting it up as soon as we have some proper staffing in place right now. We're trying to staff our business right now so that we can put proper people in place so we can focus on setting up some more things for breaks and whatever else. But for right now, we're short-staffed, so some things have gone by the wayside. And setting up additional personal break fund like that is one of them. But hopefully by midsummer we might be able to get around to doing some more of that fun stuff, but we'll see. It also depends on the types of products we have in stock. It depends on where pricing is on all these products as well. It's been kind of difficult since the hobby took a boom. Yeah, there's the Luis Robert base card. We saw the purple chrome earlier that has the RC logo on it. There's the base, obviously not supposed to be an RC. Not really, says, trying to catch something good. All right, buddy, that's cool. That's also fun. Sit back and see if anything comes your way. We got a short print here behind Justin Dunn. Or something backwards. I'm not going to say short print, but yes. It does say action, and it's going to be Sixto Sanchez on the action variation, which is, once again, not an action card, not an action photo, but Topps has been enjoying effing with us, all of us, and our brains. Mountcastle. We landed on the moon! Who's gonna be the next in line? Who's gonna be the next in line for pack rips? Just turned 6 o'clock, it's 6:01, so we got about 59 minutes left in the regularly scheduled program. The guy that was talking smack the other day, was this the guy? I think Profar, Dodgers and Padres, and there was that issue between whether if it was a fair swing or an unfair swing, or if it was interference on the catcher's part. I think that was the kid, and he was throwing some words back and forth to the Dodgers. Well, the home run leaders on this card, 2020. Six packs to go, counting this one in my hand. Let's see if we come up on a hit here. I'm going to say it's going to be right here in this left pack. Noble saying that swing was weak. It definitely wasn't the best swing in the world. I mean, it was a weak swing, yes. Here's a hit. I knew it. It's Jorge Alfaro. I knew it was going to be in the left pack for some reason. Jorge Alfaro clubhouse relic. Do you watch any other pack opening YouTubers? On occasion, just to get an idea of what some other guys are doing out there right now, but not with any real serious other interest outside of that. Mainly just for business research purposes. Here's Joey Bart. Clemente, the great one. Mike Trout in action there. Last pack in the box for Ed. Hap, Castellanos, some RBI leaders, a little funky Muncy there, Bichette, Chatwood, Clemente, Perez, and Cron. And that's the way that box is going to go for you, Ed. Not thrilling, but nice. There you go, Ed. And the time keeps on spinning into the future. Thanks, Ed, for that rip. Might have to try again, he says. Yeah, you might have to. I'm going to go check the computer and see if anybody else is trying something else. I'll be back to tell you guys what's up. Shane Hogan in the group chat bringing up an incredible question, a poignant question. Who's buying in next? So far, nobody. If you're thinking about checking out right now, pull the trigger. Give us something to rip. Because I'm just sitting here watching the wheels spin. People say I'm crazy. Doing what I'm doing. Give me all kinds of warnings to save me from ruin. When I say that I'm okay, will they look at me kind of strange? Surely you're not happy now, you no longer play the game. People say I'm lazy, dreaming my life away. Well, they give me all kinds of advice designed to enlighten me. When I tell them I'm doing fine, watching shadows on the wall, don't you miss the big time, boy, you're no longer on the ball. I'm just sitting here watching the wheels go round and round. I really love to watch them roll. No longer riding on the merry-go-round. I just had to let it go. I am, Ben. This is the John Lennon version of that song. People asking questions, lost in confusion. Well, I tell them there's no problem, only solutions. Well, they shake their heads and they look at me as if I've lost my mind. Told them there's no hurry, I'm just sitting here doing time. I'm just sitting here watching the wheels go round and round. I really love to watch them roll. No longer riding on a merry-go-round. Let it go. Winning in. I just had to let it go. Winning in. I just had to let it go. Just spinning our wheels here, folks. If there's nothing going on in the next 15 minutes, we're going to call it a night, folks. I'm going to go check the computer and keep my fingers crossed. Keep your fingers crossed that maybe something came through the wire here. Ed has made the decision to run back the Heritage. And hey, good for you, Ed. You activated the Heritage raffle, so that's we're going to be raffling off a box of Heritage. And Ed has a 2-1 lead right now over Jamie, I think, who bought the first box tonight. So anybody else wants to buy a box of Heritage tonight, we are going to be raffling one off. All right, Ed, this box starts with a box topper of Yoan Moncada. Oversized box loader card. Let's get into it. We need to sell one more 16x20 to activate that raffle tonight. And two more boxes of Inception to activate that raffle. So if that inspires anybody else out there to jump in, plus you get discounts on those products as well. Check out the discount codes on the right-hand side of your screen. And name me one other company that's giving back more to the hobby people than we are. Name one other company that's giving back more to the collectors than we are. With our free shipping, with our 5% back, with our discount codes, with our raffle items. And our 40 years of service in the card industry. Gotta be better than the last box, Ed. It is Heritage, though, so does it? Doesn't have to be better. Hopefully it will be better. Inception's been pretty hot right now, too, everybody. Inception has been pretty hot. If you guys want to dip into some more Inception, we've already hit a Cabrian Hayes RPA tonight out of Inception. See what's behind Rob Grossman here. Got a little black border card. Mateo and Olivares. Not numbered, but still cool. Thanks, Cameron, for saying that. We understand there's a bunch of places to go and shop for cards right now, folks, but we appreciate your support of our longtime family business, the longest running business in the card industry. New Age. Thank you. least Robert in action. Anyone want to jump in after this box? Get into some Inception, some Heritage, or some Gold Rush tonight, or anything else we have available. You can use the link that's pinned to the top of the group chat to check out our personal break items that we have. Jump on a purchase and you'll be in the lineup right away. Mountcastle. Six packs to go. Well, in the last box, the hit was right here, so I'm actually going to save that one. Just because. Let's see if the hit comes out in a different pack right now, or if it's getting into a rut. No hit there. Bobichet, Kershaw, Watergate scandal begins with break-in, Woodward, Bernstein, Andrew C. wants to know, what's the best hit so far? Anybody want to tell him? Anybody remember what kind of hits we've had tonight? Because I don't. There's Carlton and Bauer. Carlton rocking a nice mustache on the left there. Last pack before I get into the one that I think holds the hit. Let's see what's in here. Tommy Malone, Jackie, it's going to be some kind of a relic, hopefully it's a cool relic, nope, sorry Ed, I was keeping my legs crossed for you the whole time. Hunter Dozier, base relic. And a little black border parallel, and whatever else you may have spotted that I missed, or whatever else you might spot in that box that I missed. But man, that was a rough 1-2 punch for Ed B. But hopefully you're having a good time with us, Ed, and it's providing you a little bit of entertainment. A little bit of entertainment this evening, and maybe it gives you a reason to crack another cold one. Check the orders, see if anything's coming in. I'll be back when I got something to rip. right. Ed has always been a good sport. Win some, lose some. That's right. He knows. He knows how it rolls. Aaron N. also knows how it works. He's jumping on some Heritage. First and foremost, purchase a product because you're interested in it, folks. That's probably the best way to enjoy a hobby. Do it because you're interested. And if you get something valuable, that's icing on the cake. So Aaron, let's see what happens with your box of Heritage. Starting off with a better box topper. It's Clemente. Nice. That's cool. Love the blue background there. That's clean. That's one of my favorite photos of Clemente there. All right, Aaron N., this box is for you. Starting off with Daniel Hudson. Judge. Dobnak in there. I just like saying the name Dobnak. Ooh, you got some red chrome in this pack here. How's that doing? Maybe that's good. Ed B is watching this right now. He might get pissed if it's a big card. Let's see who it is. Sick. Alec Bohm, Spencer Howard on the team color red parallel chrome. Out of five? No. It's out of 372. Still nice looking. Just kidding, I know. All that stuff I was talking about, Ed B being a good sport, you would never get pissed in a real way. Only jokingly, of course. But that's part of the fun, also. There's Aaron. What's up, buddy? Chilling here on a Monday evening here, April 19th. Heimer Candelario. Heimer. Got about 20 minutes left in the regularly scheduled program. Ooh, how about a Jeff McNeil on card autograph jumping out there? So Ed B definitely took one for the team, took two for the team, and made room for Aaron's box to have an on-card autograph and a red parallel chrome. We're not even halfway through the box. So thanks to Ed B, on Aaron's behalf, I'm going to say, for clearing out a couple of dead boxes. Mark O adding, Heritage can be rough. On the other hand, there are some hidden gems that can be found. Yeah, like I've always maintained about Heritage, it is a set builder's set. It's really to be collected just because you like to build the sets, you like the designs, the retro designs, and if you happen to get a cool hit, then that's just a bonus. But it's by no means expected, in my opinion. And I think it's a pretty good way to look at it. Here's Cabrian Hayes on a New Age. I think that's a pretty good way to look at it. Makes it hurt a little bit. Helps it to hurt a little bit less. Takes a little sting off, too. Dow Jones closes above 1,000 for the first time in 1972. Who's this Dow Jones fella? I thought that pack felt a little heavy and thick. That's because it's got 11 cards in it as opposed to the 9 that it's only supposed to have. It's kind of interesting. That can happen. Half a dozen packs left in this box, counting the one in my hand here. Let's see, you got a chrome card. White parallel, it's going to be Luis Garcia and Christian Pache. Little dual rookie stars card. Numbered out of 999. Backwards card is going to be, I don't see any action or anything, but it's Tatis. And I think this is one of the flip stocks. Yeah, this is a flip stock card. So it has the rough side on the front and the smooth side on the back, as opposed to the other way around, which is how they do it for the base card. Smooth on the front and rough on the back. So this is a Tatis flip stock parallel, which probably is a pretty good thing to have. Even though Tatis is kind of struggling out of the gate this season, still a lot of people banking on this kid. And yeah, once again, hats off to Ed B for moving the dead boxes out of the way. That's too bad, Ed. But congratulations to Aaron having a nice box. Could have been either one of you guys. It could have been anybody. You never know. It's just playing with superstition at this point. Ed says, we'll take donations. Cameron D adding, supposedly they only made 5 of each of those? Wow. Then that Tatis has to be real nice then, huh? If that's the truth, dang. Wow. So Aaron N. jumping into some heritage. And it's paying off for him in the luckiest of ways. Well, one of the luckiest of ways. Here's the last pack in your box, Aaron. So Michael Conforto rounding out the box, but wow. 2 chrome cards. Both dual rookie stars. The one on the left is red. The one on the right is white, obviously. We got the, I just sleeved up the Cabrian New Age just because. But then you got the Tatis flip stock and the Jeff McNeil on-card autograph heritage. Just kind of keeping up. At least the good boxes that we found have been pretty good. And the bad boxes we found have been terrible. That's the way that's been going for us. But That was a good box. Congratulations, Aaron. Give me a moment to go check the lineup to see if anything else snuck through on the purchases here. We got about 14 minutes left in the original scheduled program here, folks. If you want to get something in the lineup, do it now. If you're waiting, I'll find it when I go check out right now. Otherwise, we'll probably be getting out of here at 7 o'clock. So, who else wants to jump in? I was just checking out the pack odds on this on these flip stock cards. Pack odds are 1 in 778 packs, says right up there at the top, flip stock, 1 to 778, which is about 32 boxes. One per every 32 boxes on these flip stocks, which I always like to do this. If you bought 32 boxes at $135 a box, it's approximately $4,376 you'd have to spend in order to find one of these. Then that's not even guaranteeing that it would be someone cool like Tatis. So, surprisingly actually, these don't sell for much more than $200. I feel like they should sell for more based on the odds, but still a great pull. We're probably going to be wrapping it up here. If anyone wants to pull the trigger on something, do it right now. Otherwise, we're going to be wrapping up the program here tonight in about the next 5 minutes, folks. 5 minute warning. Gonna go ahead and set up for the raffle here. The only product pool that got activated for the raffle is Heritage. People were jumping on Heritage tonight. Not a ton of people. Only ripped four boxes. Ed got two of them. Aaron, and then I believe it was someone else who I'm forgetting right now. Let me check. But Aaron says that's the second flip card we pulled for him. What was the first? Just out of curiosity. All right, folks, I think this is gonna do it for us. This was the only raffle that was activated from this evening. was the Topps Heritage box. So we're going to raffle off one of those to one of the three lucky participants. Ed B., you got a 50-50 chance right now because you have two spots. Jamie G. has one, and Aaron N. has the other one. The other products did not get activated, excuse me. Thank you, Bubble Pog. Have a lovely night yourself, and see you all on Wednesday. Happy to have you with us. All right, Aaron, Jamie, and Ed, follow me to the randomizer screen. There's the names in the order that you guys bought in. Jamie got the first box, which was an excellent box. Aaron bought the last box, which was a good box. And Ed B. got the shaft in the middle. But who knows, maybe his two spots will pay off and give him an edge in this raffle. Let's see how it's going to go. Let's roll the dice here. Dice coming up with nine times. Josh P., see you Wednesday. Nine times? I don't remember him being sick nine times. I just don't remember. Here we go, guys. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and here is the ninth and final roll. I hate to see Ed's name at the top both spots right now on the second to last roll. Let's see how it rolls out here. Here's nine. Good luck, everybody. Nine, and Aaron. Aaron pulling out to be the winner of that box. Hey, some guys have all the luck. Ed B. has had his nights here before, too, so I don't feel too bad. I want everybody to win, but obviously that's not possible. But Aaron, look at you. There you go, buddy. Hopefully you're still watching there in the background. Boom, baby. He sure is. There it is, buddy. The randomizer has spoken. The sticker is on. I'm going to put him right on DeGrom's face right there. And we're going to get out of here, or at least I am going to get out of here. Figure, says Ed. Ed, we love you, buddy. Hope you're having a good night. Get some rest tonight, and let's try again on Wednesday. Thanks to you guys that support us tonight by jumping in. We appreciate you. Another fun night here held by me, Card Shop Eric, at America's longest-running family-owned brick and mortar in the card industry right here in Arcadia, California. Come back and join us on Wednesday, won't you, folks? Have a good rest of your night.